So Christmas and the new year are approaching, and I don't know about you, but I could sure use a break from my Etsy shop and my handmade business for at least a week between Christmas and New Year. However, you might not want to close your Etsy shop or put it on vacation mode because there is small risk that you'll lose some of your momentum, some of your search positioning, things like that. And you just might not want to miss out on the sales either, even though you're not going to be wanting to work on them during that period. So today I'm going to talk about what I do and have been doing for many, many years now, which is taking a making break rather than closing my business. And I'm going to explain exactly how you can do the same so that you have all the sales you could want in that period, happy customers, and you can relax and get back to work after the new year. G'day there, welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Jess Van Den. I've been running my own successful jewelry business, Ethereal, since I opened my first Etsy shop in 2008, and that same shop is still going strong today. And since 2013, I've been helping other makers like you and me take their handmade hobby and turn it into a thriving and profitable business. So that's what we're talking about today. Okay, so how can you take a proper break between Christmas and New Year without losing any of your Etsy SEO juice that you've built up, while also not having to worry about checking messages and, you know, making sure that your customers aren't unhappy in this period of time? The first thing you need to think about, and I think a lot of people stress about this, is, okay, my shop's going to be open, people might still be sending me messages. And look, it's up to you whether you want to reply to those or not. What we're talking about here is having a break from making and shipping stuff. So you're having a break definitely from any production and any shipping during this period. And ideally, you're having a break completely from any communication or social media or marketing as well. But that is up to you. That might not be, you know, you might not be comfortable going quite that far. But generally speaking, that's what I do, is have a full break. Sometimes I might check things just once in the middle, just to kind of check in. But I'm going to talk today about how to do this and have a complete break without having to worry about that. So if that sounds good, let's get into it. So the most important thing about doing this is communication, communication, communication. Making sure that your customers and your potential customers know exactly what you are doing and the dates that you are doing it. So the first thing you need to decide is exactly what sort of break you're going to be taking and what your close and open dates are going to be. Generally, what I will do is I will take my break starting the 24th, so the day before Christmas, and I'll generally finish that break on the 2nd of January, because I don't know about you, but I don't feel like doing anything on the 1st of January after New Year's. So, or alternatively, like the first Monday after New Year's, if it's on the weekend, for example. So that gives you, you know, at least a week of time that you're going to be taking a break. And again, you need to decide, am I just going to take a making and shipping break, or am I going to take a complete break from emails, messages, etc.? That's two different levels. So let's talk through that. No matter what, the first step is you need to put the announcement everywhere. So if you have an Etsy shop, which is basically what we're talking about today, but this applies on your own website as well, you want to put a notice or a notification where people will see it. So update your banner, update your announcement, and use the bulk editing feature to update all of your descriptions. So what you can do is in Etsy, you can go into the editor, select all of your products, and then bulk edit your descriptions to add at the beginning this information about your making break, so that your customers, when they go and see any of your items, will see this and know what's going on. It's very simple. You want to write something like, I will be taking a making break between this date and this date. This means I will not be making or shipping any orders. And then you can also say, or answering any messages during this time. Then the important thing to add to that is, all orders placed before this date have been shipped. You know, just to make sure anyone who's, you know, contacting you, who like, oh, has my order been shipped? You're just clarifying that yes, all orders, you know, placed before this date have been completed and shipped. And so that's another thing you have to decide is, okay, am I going to finish a little bit earlier? Am I going to like start this on the 20th of December so I have time to catch up and stop? Or am I just going to, you know, keep taking orders and just keep working right up until the time, and then, you know, on the 24th, go to the post office and drop off all the orders? that's something that's going to be up to you. Generally, we'll try to close or stop taking orders, you know, like I said, on the 24th or 23rd. Generally, things are pretty slow those few days just before Christmas anyway, because most people have, you know, done their Christmas shopping, or it's pretty obvious if they're coming to our shop, they can't order for Christmas because we have it blasted everywhere that Christmas orders are done and over by that point in time. So another thing you might want to put in here, and what you're definitely going to want to put in your autoresponder, is that you're not accepting urgent or rush orders during this time. And if somebody has placed one of those orders, you won't be able to fulfill it, and that you will cancel and refund on your return. So that's in case you get those people who just put in those orders and expect you to do it the next day, even though it's the holiday period, you're explaining to them, this is what's going to happen. So that's if you're going to the level of having a full break, you want to set up an autoresponder on your Etsy shop, and also possibly on your social media. If a lot of customers find you via like Facebook, for example, you can actually set up an autoresponder to anyone who messages you on those platforms as well. And you're going to write the same thing for all the platforms explaining what's happening. So remember, you want to explain the date you're closing, the date you're reopening, exactly what you're not doing and what you are during that time. So, hey, we're taking a making break. Our shop remains open for orders, but we won't start processing any orders until January 2nd. That's also when we'll get back to any messages that we've received during that time. And then finish off that or with something like, thank you for understanding while we take this break at the end of the year and spend time with our family. We hope you're having a wonderful holiday period as well. So it's that, you know, finishing off on a high note, explaining and making it clear to people that you're a real person, you're a solo business owner, you need some time to relax and decompress, but that, hey, your shop's staying open because you're only taking a week off and you're going to get right back to it after the new year. One important thing you need to do here is turn off your notifications so you don't get derailed by all the bing, bing, bing and happening, right? Now, I'm a big fan of not having notifications on ever anyway, but if you are the sort of person who has that Etsy notification so you get the cha-ching when you make a sale, you want to turn all that off, because if you don't turn it off, then Pavlov's dog response is going to happen when somebody messages you or you make a sale, and you're just going to be like, I'll just check that, you know. You can't help it. So you need to turn off all your notifications so you're not tempted to be sucked into the vortex of work during that time. So turn off all your social notifications, turn off your email notifications, turn off your Etsy notifications, and just go, if I really freak out and feel like I need to check stuff, I can, but I don't need the platforms telling me that I'm getting stuff, you know, sales and messages and so on, because that will stress me out. Now, the last stage here is to plan a day to catch up when you come back to work. Okay, so depending on how much time you've taken off, you might want to know, okay, well, that first day back, I'm going to need time to catch up replying to any messages and emails because I've taken that week off. I'm going to need a bit of time to, you know, write down all my orders and then start processing those new orders. You may also like to, at this point, if you normally have a really short turnaround time, you might want to change your shipping times on your products to reflect the break that you're taking. So I already have a 1 to 2 week turnaround shipping time on my product. And when we come back from our making break, we try to get stuff done really quickly so that we're still kind of inside that 2 week window, because we're only taking, you know, 10 days off or something like that. But if you normally have, you know, a 1 to 2 day turnaround, just go change all your shipping times on all your products so that it's 1 to 2 weeks at least. So that way, when somebody goes to order while you're having your break, they'll see that is an extended shipping time and they won't suddenly think, oh, I'm still going to get this thing within 1 to 2 days. So that's a really important part of the process too, to make sure you're not confusing people. Because as we all know, people often don't read. That's why you need to put these notifications everywhere you possibly can, your banner, your description, have an autoresponder. Now, one little caveat here, the autoresponder on Etsy only will work for 5 days, Okay, so if you're taking more than 5 days off, you are going to have to hop in and turn it off and on again so that it will keep going for the rest of your break. So just make a note in your calendar or whatever, however you do it. I just usually put it in my Google calendar and make it ping me. So that's one ping I do leave on to remind me to go back in there and to just switch that off and on again so that it restarts the 5 days. And people are definitely getting this message every time they message me. And that's it. This way, by taking a making break instead of actually shutting your shop, you can keep the orders coming in, keep your search positions, your search rankings, don't lose any of that momentum with your shop, but you still get to have a break and you can relax a bit. Now, I've done this at other times of the year as well. I've taken a making break for a week here and there. It's a little bit more difficult during other times of the year because people aren't expecting you to be on holidays, but honestly, between Christmas and New Year, anyone who's rude about you having a holiday is not somebody you want as a customer, as far as I'm concerned, because people need to understand that we're real people. We have families. We have the need for downtime. We want to relax and enjoy the holiday season as much as anyone else. And usually we've been working our ass off up to Christmas, fulfilling Christmas orders. So we definitely need that little bit of downtime. So don't let that worry you. If you end up getting an irate customer or something, so what? Like, that stuff happens sometimes, no matter what you do. So don't think about that. Just think about yourself and your family. Put yourself first during this period of time. The people who really want what you have to offer will understand, and they will be willing to wait for you to have a nice break and then get back to work. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please do give me a thumbs up. Let me know in the comments if you're going to try having a making break this year instead of maybe shutting your shop or just working on through because you're too worried about shutting your shop because you think it's going to destroy your business. Spoiler alert, it's not, but it does have a small impact. So this is a way to get around that. Okay. And this is from somebody who has shut her shop for literally months at a time and then gotten back into it. So, you know, if you want to shut as well, then just shut. That's okay, you'll get back on it. But this is a video for those who don't want to do that, who just want to take a break, but want to keep perhaps a little bit of money coming through the door at the same time. I'll be back again soon with another video. Thanks for watching and bye for now.